Hey, how you doing, Professor Thompson? Me and Brandon, we chose to do assignment 4A, which was The New Negro by Alain Locke. Basically, I'd be asking some questions. And the first question would be, what does it mean to be a new Negro?
Well, pretty much after reading the story, I learned that the New Negro was actually a movement. Movement started roughly in the 1930s, and the movement was pretty much to push our people, the black people, push our people to not settle. In my words, I feel like it's to not settle and to push our people beyond the boundaries, to not just be a slave or a servant or a maid to the people who don't appreciate us, the people who are just using us for free to get what they want. The purpose of the movement was to push our people to different levels and to be prosperous and successful in everything that we do. Again, like I said, it was pretty much in the early 1900s. So this was during this time when the Jim Crow laws were instated. So pretty much, after I was reading the story, it was pretty much saying how the slaves at the time would leave the South, the Southern states, and move towards the North to help find jobs and to help get their, to start their careers. And pretty much the new Negro was motivation to help push them to different levels and to continue to prosper and flourish in all their lives.
Good. The second question, what did you learn in general?
Well, what did I learn in general? Pretty much, I actually have never heard of this movement. I've heard of the Renaissance movement, all this stuff, but I never heard of the term New Negro, pretty much. But after reading the story, it gave me a really good insight on exactly what helped push our people to different heights and what helped pushes our people to this day to continue to progress in everything that we do and to never settle and not to just be someone's slave or servant, but to be the person who is a boss, who is a CEO, who is a founder, who is a leader, and to bring people into this world who are able to have that same mindset. So I've learned a lot from reading this.
All right. In the 21st century, in your perspective, what would it mean to be a new Negro?
Well, in the 21st century, unfortunately, we have a very horrible president in office, but I'm not going to, that's people's political views. But I believe what it means to be a new Negro now is to, I believe one is being optimistic. Optimism is a key to success now, and it's always been that way. To never settle, to always be positive, and to always push when things are not looking well. First would be optimism. Second would be courage, to step in boundaries that have never been stepped in before, and to try new things, and to focus on trying to be successful in everything that we do. I believe that being a Negro also means to never settle, and to always have that want, that drive to learn more about you and who you are, and always continue to be flourish and be successful in everything that we do. I think that's one of the biggest things that I learned from it, was the understanding that, you use this movement to help push you. Even when we run into the 21st century where times are not, this world was not designed for us. This world is designed to use us and to use us for pretty much little to nothing. So we have to realize that. And realize that we are here to stay. We are people, regardless of what color, what nationality, we are people, and we are here to stay. We have tools and crafts that other people do not have. And it's important that we use our tools to be successful in everything that we do. I mean, that's pretty much why I feel about it, and everybody feels their way about it. I mean, how do you